Constitutional Conversations is a series of discussions by America's leading scholars about the principles, framing, ratification, and implementation of constitutional government in the United States. This series is hosted by the James Madison Memorial Fellowship Foundation of Alexandria, Virginia.
If you stopped the typical American on the street and asked them who are the founding fathers, you're likely to get a very short list. Washington almost always is included on that list. And I think most Americans can give a handful of individuals, a Washington, a Jefferson, a Franklin, a Madison perhaps. But I think we do a disservice and we don't get an accurate picture if we stop with those very famous founders. There was certainly an expansive body of men and women who played a key role in the formation of the American Republic. And I think it's an important part of our understanding of what transpired in the last third of the 18th century and the political society that they created if we don't include in that fraternity of founders a number of other individuals. In fact, I would like to think of it as an entire generation or two of Americans who played a vital, salient role in not only articulating their rights, but also creating new constitutional republics. Consider, for example, a Roger Sherman of Connecticut. He was a simple cobbler, but played a very important role. When we look at the history of the American founding, we're going to find him there in the midst of key decisions, important actions. This is an individual who was very much a part of the First and Second Continental Congresses, one of those individuals who was actually in the chambers of that Congress, perhaps as much as any other individual. He's on the Committee of Five that was assigned the task of crafting a Declaration of Independence. He was involved in crafting the Articles of Confederation, this first charter, if you will, of the Union following independence. And he's going to be there again in the chambers of the Constitutional Convention in Philadelphia. He's going to be one of the most vocal of delegates, playing a key role. He's often credited as being one of the key individuals who proposed what's sometimes called the Connecticut Compromise that broke a logjam in that convention. And so in many respects, he's making decisive decisions. He's involved in critical debates. And it's hard to imagine the unfolding of the American independence movement without a Roger Sherman. And yet, if you stop someone on the street, I dare say they wouldn't know who Roger Sherman is today. And so here's a good example of an individual that's largely forgotten, but is a key figure in the American founding. And we could say the same about a whole host of other individuals, people like a John Dickinson or a John Witherspoon or an Elbridge Gerry, and the list goes on and on. So I think it's vitally important that as we study the American founding and as we study our constitutional republic, that we include in that study an examination of these individuals who are now forgotten but were key figures in their own time and at this momentous time in American history.
Constitutional Conversations is made possible by a generous grant from the Fairleigh S. Dickinson Jr. Foundation. Constitutional Conversations is made possible by the James Madison Education Fund.